The Workload Insights feature of the SSMC Management Console for HPE 3-part and Primera storage adds application awareness and intelligence to storage management. The dashboard for each storage array gives a quick view of the performance and capacity, including application sets that allow you to monitor each application as a whole. The dashboard shows the top application hotspots by throughput and latency. Each has a performance score between 0 and 10, where a higher number indicates increased contention. Let's drill down on VMware, since it has the highest score in both categories. In the application set screen, we can select the performance view in order to see the IOPS, service time, and bandwidth for a given application. Hovering over a point in time allows us to compare the read and write percentages of the peak periods to those times with lighter workloads. The system retains high-res data, so we can click on the graph to see detail from any interval and isolate the components of the app set at the host, port, or volume level. Grouping the data by virtual volume name shows us that all of VMware volumes participate equally in driving bandwidth during these spikes. The fact that the I/O is 100% read could also be a clue as to the cause. The SSMC has a feature called Topology Insights, which would allow us to diagnose performance down to the individual VM level, but we'll explore that further in a separate video. Instead, let's go to the map view for the application, which shows its end-to-end topology and the association with the volumes, hosts, host ports, and controller nodes of the storage array. Before we go, we'll show how easy it is to create your own app set. An app set is created simply by tagging a group of volumes on the array with an application type. You can select existing volumes or create new ones. We're going to create an Oracle application and provision two new 10 gigabyte storage volumes. Workload Insights also makes it easy to choose the system that's the best fit for our application. The three available systems are ranked by system saturation level. This percentage is calculated using advanced analytics, incorporating the array configuration and its specific workload fingerprint, comparing that to similar systems in our install base, and then projecting out 3.5 days into the future. After also taking into account the free capacity on each storage array, it's apparent that the first system in the list is the best choice. The only remaining step is to select the media and RAID type for our volumes, and we're all done. We can now go back to the map view, where we can see the topology for our newly created Oracle application set.